so just a quick book placement, product placement for my books under the author named Derek Hemenway. First, we have the first installment in The Human Saga, which is my epic trilogy of novellas about a future civilization of corporate fascism that is being invaded by an alien cult. We have The Mortician's Daughter, a dark fantasy set in Mesoamerica about a sorceress who blocks out the sun to create a kingdom of darkness and evil full of ghosts and monsters. It's fucking awesome. Part 2 of The Human Saga, and then Part 3. There's currently my first full-length novel in the works, so be on the lookout for that. That's about all. Song Snob Reacts!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Nathan's Song Snob. And today we're going to be reacting to another video by Poppy, entitled Flux. She'll be fluxing for us today. The flux capacitor is fluxing. Fun fact, I do an impression that no one else, as far as I know, does. If you remember George McFly from Back to the Future, Marty's dad, I'm pretty sure I'm the only person in the world who does Crispin Glover. I haven't done it in a long time. I might do that for you at the end of the video as something a little entertaining. I just remembered that as kind of a funny joke. with that being said, we're going to be doing Poppy Flux. And I'm looking forward to this song because I really like Poppy. I do sometimes like pop artists, but I'm pretty hard on the pop industry much of the time because pop music is pretty unsophisticated and unsatisfying. There's a reason why I'm called a song snob. I'm very picky and I have high standards when it comes to music. I am unapologetic about that in every conceivable fashion, just so you know. Anyway, let's get into it. It begins in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and go.
Thank you.
Well, I think Poppy is endlessly entertaining, largely because she does this thing where she'll mix imagery. We have an otherwise very attractive young lady walking through in the video what looks like sort of like a candy land. Everything's very saccharine and sweet. But the sound of the music itself is anything but. I like how she sort of contrasts that imagery of like sweet and nice things, but with something that sounds kind of edgy and vile. That creates such an odd contrast that it makes it very entertaining. I very much enjoy Poppy. I think this is probably my favorite song of hers so far that's been more rock and roll or heavy metal. And you can't go wrong with just a straightforward rock song, which is basically what this is. I particularly liked the rhythm and percussion. The drums and the other percussive instruments were very nice. I like the arrangement. It's nice and full. It's very robust sounding. It's very full. There's no melodies that are excessively repetitive. It's all a matter of taste. If you like a sort of just basic straight-ahead rock song, this is for you. Excuse me. There's nothing in particular I find wrong with it. This is my favorite of hers thus far. Very nice. In retrospect, it does kind of remind me a little bit. I meant to say something about it. It does remind me somewhat of sort of the early 2000s modern rock or heavy alt scene, which I was a huge fan of as a teenager and still am to some degree. I've often find that music makes me feel very euphoric, weirdly enough. I have strong visceral reactions to things. I can sort of feel it in my body, and there's certain music I won't listen to if it just doesn't feel right. If I hear it, my body reacts to it negatively. But her music, I cannot say that of that. Her music, I have a very strong positive reaction to it. All in all, this was not a bad bit of music. I very much liked it. Now, with that being said, I would rate it at, for what it is, 5 out of 5. Because it being basic, that's a matter of taste. You can either like it basic or you can like it more sophisticated. It really depends. So, rating on what it is, this is 5 out of 5. Can't believe I said that about a pop star. I think I'm a huge Poppy fan now. So lyrical breakdown, the part that many people seem to not like very much, but I'm going to do it anyway because it is for Poppy. Now, verse 1, my body is fluid because I've been through it all. Chewed up and used, it's cut into pieces to feed them all. Very interesting. Because I've been through it all. So you're saying that you've been through every pain, every torture, life is suffering, etc., etc. you've been chewed up and used, thrown away like an object, and as a result, it's made you fluid. You've been cut up into pieces, feeding everyone else. You've just been used, and now you're fluid. That sounds legitimately horrible. For your amusement, for your confusion, I guess I'll do it because I'm bored. And no attention span is shorter than mine or yours. Ouch. So you're saying that it's all for their amusement, that your pain is for their amusement, for their confusion. You'll do it because you're bored, like you have no better reason to do it. That's sad. That's sad. And admittedly, very few people suffer as much as recording artists who are simply looking to entertain. Right, recording artists go through insane forms of suffering and frustration just to give a good performance. For example, Till Lindemann of Rammstein very famously had a dentist drill a hole into his cheek and install a light bulb at the back of his mouth, going that extra mile to entertain a crowd. Personally, I think Till Lindemann was a little out of his mind, but that's just my opinion. But she's doing it because she's bored, maybe, or maybe she has no other reason, no rational reason, certainly. She's doing it because she can or because she wants to. Her attention span is short, so is yours. Because modern entertainment is faster, quicker, it's shorter, so you're not testing your attention span as much, and so it does not grow. And anything that isn't tested doesn't grow. You can't oppose it. That's just how it goes. Yeah, you got to flux and flow with it. You can't oppose it. That's just how it goes. Yeah. The chorus more or less affirming my assertion that you basically get nowhere living your life always swimming upstream because it just slows you down and it turns into a slog. You have to let the flow of the river carry you to some extent, even if that means going over a waterfall, because there's no point in fighting it. You can either get there painfully or painlessly, but you're going to get there. Require no permission. Just ask for forgiveness. There's no second guessing. I'm just a possession. Ouch. So she's definitely feeling objectified by her audience. That's legitimately horrible. I'm sorry that you feel that way, Poppy. For your amusement, for your confusion, basically repeated pre-chorus. Same chorus. Bridge. I won't fear what I don't know. You gotta flux and flow. I won't fear what I don't know. And then you just repeat that a few lines. Repeat the same chorus from before with the bridge attached, as well as an outro. The lyrics, once again, are overly repetitive. I know that's a thing with me. Overly repetitive, that's a point away. That makes it 4 out of 5 already. But I think this comes to a very painful and ultimately tragic meaning. Because oftentimes celebrities feel like they've been rendered as an object and are no longer a person. They don't feel human anymore. They feel like they've been objectified, turned into an object, made to feel less than, just for someone else's entertainment. And that is, again, legitimately horrible. And I'm sure many celebrities probably feel that way. I'm sure Billie Eilish feels that way. I'm sure many performing artists feel that way. And it's sad that they do. And unfortunately, I kind of think that they're maybe kind of right in a lot of ways, that they are rendered as an object instead of a person, which is beyond sad and greatly inappropriate. You're not supposed to treat people that way. Not really. But what's interesting is when she says that I won't fear what I don't know, which is interesting because fearing what you don't know is just human nature. When you're anticipating something but you're not sure where it's coming from or what it even is, you fear the unknown. And I don't think a fight against human nature is a fight you can honestly win. I mean, you can try, sure, but can you say honestly that you're going to come anywhere close to succeeding in that fight? I seriously doubt it. So ultimately, I think that Poppy feels like she's exchanging one fight and just going with the flow and trading in for another, which is the fight to, you know, fight the fear of the unknown and to just go wherever the flow takes you, to flux in that direction. It's not very human, but it does seem like a better way to be. But it is definitely not very human. Lyrically speaking, the rhyme scheme is simple, but that's a taste thing. It's very well done. It is certainly not juvenile. But you're not going to get much sophistication from a pop star, unfortunately, on lyrics. I'm not trying to be overly critical. That's just the truth. This is out of 4 out of 5, as far as lyrics, but 5 out of 5 on music. So take that as you will. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that'll be it for rating Poppy. Now, because I thought about Back to the Future, I have to do, because I said I was going to do it. This is my thing. Hold on a second. Hold on a second. But yeah, I have a number of impressions I do, and this, as far as I know, this is the only one. I'm the only person in the world who does this particular impression. The real trick to it is just to kind of exhale after every word, sort of like you're having like a half orgasm. You have like a weird glow, and you just try to sound as pathetic as humanly possible. And then occasionally you get really excited, but back off a little because you don't want to be too excited because you're secretly very depressed. And that's sort of how you do it. Hey, you! Get your damn hands off her! Oh. Last night, Darth Vader came down from planet Vulcan and told me that if I didn't take Lorraine out, that he'd melt my brain. But yeah, that's pretty sure that I'm the only person in the world who does that particular impression. But I think it's hilarious. And for some reason, the word flux got me on that sidetrack. Anyway, I'm sorry it's so dark in here. I'll probably do some post-edit to lighten up the room. It's very warm in here today. Anyway, with that being said, there'll be a link in the description below to my books. Please buy, download, and read them. And as always, tschüss, peace.